Hello and welcome to this week's question with me, Mars Brining. Now this week's question is, how do I use the combine tool? So let's flip into SOLIDWORKS and I'll show you exactly how it works. Okay, for the combine tool to be used, you must have at least two bodies within your part file. I've got two here. Let me just show you both of them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make one of these bodies. You can see here there's one and there's a second one. I'm just going to make one of these bodies transparent using this menu here. And you can see that at the moment these two bodies are intersecting one another. So if I was to maybe make this one opaque again and make this one transparent, you can see they are actually intersecting one another. If I was to hide this, you can see there is complete intersection at this end. So what I'm going to try and do here is to subtract this body from this one. Okay, I'm actually going to show you all steps within the combine tool. There's three. Alright, so one of them is my desired output and the other two I'm just going to show you exactly what they do. So to get to the combine tool, I've actually added it onto my command manager here. Okay, remember you can do that via the customize menu here. Normally though it's not there. You have to go to the insert menu, features, and then combine, which lives here. Now there's three types. You've got add, subtract, and common, and I'm going to show you all three. So add is fairly simple. Alright, you have to have at least two bodies and they have to at least be touching or intersecting one another. And if I was to pick this body and then this body and then go add, you'll see I then end up with one body with no intersections. You'll see here if I was to section this, just go straight through the middle like so, you can see here that it is just one solid lump now. Okay, so it's not Y1 in this case. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to edit this combine feature. I'm also going to show you the common function. Alright, let me just take this off section for a moment and let's just make this transparent again. So if I, whoops, let's do it before I do the combine, that's probably easier as well. So if I do common and I select both components here, remember there's intersection at this level here, okay, in this section here. So if I go common and go okay, all I'm left with is the areas where the intersection was occurring. Okay, so that's where the intersection was. Alright, that's what I'm left with. The rest of the bodies, okay, so this end here and then the other end of this body, there was no intersections occurring at that point, so therefore they're binned. Alright, again, not what I'm after in this example. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to edit this. I'm going to put it on subtract. So the main body is, so what I'm actually going to be cutting away from is this one. Alright, and then I'm going to subtract this body from it. Alright, you can see where the body's intersecting it here. And if I go OK on this, you can see now it has actually removed it from it. Alright, the only downside to using the combine tool in the subtract function like this is that body's deleted when the subtract occurs. Now there is ways around that, and you can use something called the indent tool, okay, which is this one. I won't go through it in this video, but you can use that and the cut function within it to cut away at a target body without deleting the original tooling, so to speak, body when the process is completed. But in this case, all I'm looking for is the cap with the cutout, okay, and it has actually done that. Alright, so that's how you use the combine function to produce the desired result, in this case with a subtract. Thank you for watching.